channel. So today we're going to be filming the long-awaited apartment tour, and by long-awaited I mean five of you have been asking for this video for like about a week and a half. If you didn't watch our first video, that was Eric and I moving to Maine, and then today we're just gonna film a tour of our apartment. Hope you guys enjoy it! So this is our front door, and this is what you end up seeing when you first walk into the apartment. So there's this wall here with this thing that needs to get fixed. We're waiting for maintenance. Over there is the stairs to go upstairs to the bedrooms, and then here is the kitchen. So there's nothing super fancy about our kitchen, but I do like that it's an alleyway because it's a really good way to save space. If you want to look at our cabinets, all of our stuff is either from Bed Bath & Beyond or IKEA. This knife set, my brother actually gifted this to me when I moved. This is from IKEA, this is from Target, this is from Target or Home Goods. You're gonna notice that everything is either from Amazon, Target, IKEA, or Home Goods. This paper towel holder is also from Target, and this thing was 20 bucks for a paper towel holder. That's crazy to me. This teeny tiny little rice cooker, I actually took it from my house, so we didn't have to buy a new one, which is awesome. Toaster is from Target, and then if you look in here, so this is glass Tupperware that I got from Amazon. We actually use these super often. I love this stuff. And then these cute little jars I also bought from Amazon. These stickers came with it, and you just put in like your salt, your black pepper, etc. And then I have snacks in here. Most of the snacks in here, like my chips and my Slim Jims and these delicious things, were actually gifted to me from one of my good friends, Megan, as a like goodbye gift. So Megan, if you're watching, thank you. And then these two coffee container, sugar container, also from Target. This coffee maker Eric took from home. This hot water kettle thing we also just took from my house. This microwave actually came with the apartment. So when we go over to the living room, you're gonna see that there's a big brown box on the floor. And that is the microwave that I actually bought for the apartment. So I'm a little bit annoyed that I wasn't aware that there would already be a microwave here, because then I would have just not spent money on a microwave. So one thing I wanted to show you guys about our kitchen is this calendar. Eric and I actually plan out all of our meals so a week ahead of time, so that one, we can know what we're shopping for and we don't spend money on food that we actually don't need. And then it's also just a good way to not have to panic that day and think like, what are we eating? What are we eating? Because we already have it all planned out. So this is something my cousin Lynn does, and I thought it was one of the smartest things ever. So if you ever have trouble figuring out what you want to eat for dinner, just plan it out for the whole week and then stick to it, and then it takes out all the guesswork. So now, this is our living area, which is a combination of our dining area and our living room. So this table actually belonged to the last tenant, and she sold it to me for like 100 bucks. These placemats, Amazon. This fake orchid is from Home Goods. Here's the box of the microwave. It's just sitting there. I don't know what to do with it, so it's just there. This couch is from Macy's, and these pillows are from Amazon. They were just plain white throw pillows, and then the pillowcases were also from Amazon. I found it a lot cheaper to buy pillows and cases on Amazon as opposed to buying throw pillows from even like Home Goods or Target. So I got this 4-pack of pillows and then 4 packs of cases for a lot cheaper than if I was just to buy like pre-made throw pillows. This chair right here, it also belonged to the last tenant, and I bought it off of her. This letter board, I think Eric's mom got it for us from Primark. This table, my cousin and I put this together, and it was from Overstock. And then our centerpiece here is this basket thing, which I got from maybe Home Goods. And then this fake plant is from HomeSense. My cousin Angelina picked it out. Candle is from Bed Bath & Beyond. Only buy candles from Bed Bath & Beyond. No, not Bed Bath & Beyond. Bath & Body Works. Only buy candles from Bath & Body Works when they're having that semi-annual sale. And then our coasters are from Amazon. And then I love the giant windows. And a few people have said they love the brick wall. I didn't know how I felt about the brick wall originally, but a lot of people seem to like it, so maybe I'm gonna like it. This is a puzzle that I made, and I bought it for Eric for our anniversary, and it's just a compilation of pictures of us. Behind the couch over there, those canvas pieces I actually bought off of Etsy. Almost all of the canvas pieces that are in here are from Etsy, except for a couple that my cousins actually made for me. This octopus lamp is from Target. And then over here, we have this TV stand. which is also from Overstock. This jar of Ferrero Rocher chocolates, which is from Eric's mom. This TV Eric already had. It's tiny, as you can tell. We were thinking about buying another one, but we just have to figure out the whole money situation before we go ahead and buy a new TV. And then this little glass jar I actually took from my house, and the shells in here were shells that Eric and I collected when we went to Lodholm Beach a couple weeks ago. We have a vlog up about that too, so if you're interested in seeing that, go ahead and look at that. This, my pride and joy, this is my Dyson vacuum. I got it for $100 off using a Bed Bath & Beyond coupon, so love that. This little basket right here just has like some home workout equipment. It's mainly a yoga block, which I literally don't use, and then resistance bands, and then two yoga mats. This beautiful, beautiful drawing was made for me by my cousin Angelina. It is the only piece of art on this side of the apartment. If you guys have any ideas for what we should do for the walls, because there's a lot of wall space in here and it's blank, let me know. Like, leave it down in the comments and let me know what I should be hanging on these walls, because yeah, right now they're super blank. Behind this door is a half bathroom. I'm not going to show you what it looks like because it's literally nothing fancy. It's just a toilet and a sink. Back to the entrance. Oh, I didn't even show you this closet. Closet's not really that fancy, but there are two shoe racks in here, and this is a shoe rack that I bought, and this is a shoe rack that the last tenant left for us. You know, I kind of wish she would have told us she was going to leave the shoe rack, because then again, I wouldn't have bought a shoe rack, but it is what it is. So now when we go over here, we're going up the stairs. On this little ledge here, we have this basket which just has the attachments for my Dyson vacuum. We have our masks here because COVID-19. And then this little cute, adorable elephant bowl I got from Home Goods, I think. Home Goods or Marshalls. And we just put our keys in here. So now we're gonna head up the stairs. So this is a two-bedroom apartment. Over there is our bedroom. And over there is where we have our office. So if we walk in here, I'm sorry if there's an echo, but this room is really big for just an office and we don't have that much furniture in here, so it echoes a lot. So when you walk in here, this also has a closet. We don't really put anything in this closet aside from the bins that we use to move in here. More canvas artwork from Etsy. Down here, I hate the look of the wires, but I don't know how to get rid of it. So this is our Wi-Fi router. If you guys have ideas for what we should do about those wires, yeah, also let me know, because I hate how that looks. And then over here is Eric's desk area. And then on this side is my desk area. And I just want to show you guys. You'll notice I have a thing for elephants. So this is a cute, adorable little pencil holder that I got from Amazon. It's honestly not a very, oh my god, there's stuff in here. It's not a very like logical thing to buy, because you can't really fit any, like, that many things in here. So I have a separate one that I bought from Target, not nearly as cute, but I can fit more stuff in here. So I have this one. This light is from Target. This chair is actually something that the last tenant left for me. I bought it off of her. Our two desks are from IKEA, and then Eric's office chair, it's like an ergonomic chair that his family got from a transfer station, so that was also free. And then over here on this wall, another piece of artwork that I got from Etsy. And then over here on this wall is another drawing that my cousin Angelina made me for my birthday last year. I love this thing. So much detail. I appreciate this thing so much. If you watch any of my med school vlogs, subtle plug, I also have a med school vlog channel. You'll see that in a lot of my backgrounds. Now we walk in here, and this is where we have our full bath. Another thing maintenance needs to fix, our vent doesn't work. So whenever we shower and I take steaming hot showers, it gets really suffocatingly hot in here. So come on, maintenance. This mirror is actually a mirror that the last tenants left us. So if you come into the bathroom, our floor mats are from Joblot. They are super soft, and they were like 10 bucks for both of them. And then the hand towel is from Target. This basket is also from Target, and it just has all of our skincare and hair care stuff in there. All of my soap dispensers are also from IKEA. And then, you know, toothbrush, blah, blah, blah. And another elephant that I also got from Amazon. So inside my elephant are these reusable makeup removing pads. I'm all for decreasing the amount of waste recreate in here, so that's why I have those reusable pads. This is from Target, and then the bathroom shampoo conditioner holder things are also from Amazon. So this is our closet, and this is our makeshift way of keeping the closet closed, because for some reason, it just...
Yeah, I gotta fix that.
It just opens. So I took a command hook and a piece of string, and I just hook it on to keep this door closed. This is not the most sightly closet, but you know, whatever. These are our laundry baskets. So lights in here, the basket in the back is for all of my Gymshark, because I wash all of my Gymshark separate from all my other clothes. And then this basket is for all of our dark clothes. And then here we just have extra towels, extra toilet paper, extra tissues, extra shampoo, conditioner, body wash, blah, blah, blah. And then in this box is a like first aid kit that Eric and I just put together ourselves instead of, you know, buying a first aid kit. And now we have our bedroom. I wish it was sunny today, because then like I feel like the room would look even better. But this is our bedroom. First thing you'll notice when you come in is the bed. So the mattress is actually my mom's old mattress, so we didn't have to spend hundreds of dollars on a new mattress. We love saving money, in case you haven't noticed. And then on top of the mattress is just a mattress topper that I got from Overstock. This pillow back here is actually a Hello Kitty pillow that I've had for like 10 years, but I just bought a new body pillow case from Target, and I put it on top so it would match the aesthetic of the rest of the room. The pillows were just pillows that we took from home. We didn't buy new pillows. And then the bed sheets, the blanket, the cases, they are all from Overstock. And my brother also bought me that for my birthday. Art pieces are again from Etsy. And another thing I forgot to mention is we're not allowed to punch any holes into the wall, so no screws, no nails. So all of our art piece is hung up by double-sided tape. And as you can imagine, double-sided tape doesn't always work for big art pieces. So everything is holding up right now during this video, but we have had to fix these art pieces many, many times so far. I'm really hoping that one night these things just don't fall on us while we're sleeping. This is our little walk-in closet. It's nothing fancy. Eric and I really don't have that much clothes, so sharing this closet isn't really a big deal. So, hangers, as you can see, I bought all these hangers and we don't even use them because we don't have that much clothes. This is all my stuff. And then this is like Eric's stuff up here, just like sweaters and his pants. This light is the same light that we have downstairs, except in black. And again, that's from Target. This mirror I got from Bed Bath and Beyond. And it's actually not the mirror that I ordered online. I ordered a totally different mirror, but they ended up sending me the wrong one. But it looks fine anyway. This cabinet, that desk, along with our bed frame and the little side table, those all belonged to the last tenant, and then she sold me all of that furniture for $200. This is a beautiful drawing that my cousin Audrey made for me. I sent her a picture of Eric and I holding hands, and then she recreated it through this line art. This is a, I don't know if you guys look at Katana, but there's this this artist on Instagram who makes comics, and this is a book that Eric got for me for Christmas or my birthday, and there's just like a bunch of cute comics in here that have like little relationship things that we weirdly always relate to. And then this is a book that I made for Eric for Christmas, I think, and it's just like a little cartoon rendition of our life. Again, candle is from Bath & Body Works. This desk is a little bit dinged up, but I really never use it, so I don't really care too much. I have all my makeup here, but I've literally worn makeup like 2 times since I've been here, because since medical school is online and on Zoom, no one really cares what I look like. So I haven't touched this except for today to film this video. This little side table, I'm pretty sure it's like empty.
I have some stuff.
We just have some chargers in there, and they're usually not in there. They're usually right here, but Eric decided to put them away so that the apartment would look neater. This lamp is from Target. Oh, our slippers. These are Eric's slippers. They're UGG slippers. And then these are my slippers. Oh my God, my feet. These are my slippers. I got them from Marshalls, I think. They were like $10. They're not the most logical slippers to be wearing. I find them really hard to walk up the stairs because the feet always get caught on the steps. So, you know, I do be like tripping up the stairs sometimes, but yep, these are my slippers. So now we're gonna leave the bedroom, and I think that's it. But again, all this empty wall space. So if you guys have ideas for what we should be putting here, please let me know. You know, this apartment, it is actually pretty big for just the two of us. This apartment is meant for two people. It's a two-bedroom apartment, so usually one person stays in there and one person stays in there. But since it's just me and Eric, we obviously share a bedroom, and then we created an office space to kind of separate work from relaxation. But it was the cheapest apartment that I can find, and it was the biggest one, so it just made sense to rent out this apartment. So that concludes our apartment tour. Maybe it wasn't as interesting as other apartment tours, but I'm just a very minimalist person, and I'm not a huge like home decor person. But like I said earlier, if you guys have any ideas for what we should do with the walls, text me, or if you have my number, or leave it down in the comments, because yeah, these walls are pretty blank and we do have a lot of wall space since like our ceilings are so high, and I would love to just fill up some of that space with some maybe like more paintings, or I really like when people hang plants on their walls. But again, like I said earlier, we're not allowed to like put nails in the wall or any screws into the wall, so keep in mind that if you do suggest something, it actually has to be something that can like stick on with double-sided tape. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this apartment tour. I feel like it was pretty simple. Nothing in here is super fancy. We don't really have that much stuff. I hope you guys liked it. I hope it was worth the wait for those of you who are waiting. Yeah, if you enjoy our videos, like, comment, share, and subscribe. And oh, if you're interested, you can go watch my medical school vlogs. That's it. We'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye!